Sam, that shot was one that would have gone wide, but it hit the skate of Gabrick and forced a good save.
Oh, this is a good setup in front. They score! Gabrick! Oh, beautiful play. Great finish.
And got his top line out against the Gomez line. And Jágr has it, can't clear it. Has Dimitra take it away from him. Dimitra gets it back, and what a pass and the quick shot. Again, Jágr loses it. And then what a pass. Little pass between the legs. Here comes the play. Look at Boros. What a pass.
Mark Parrish. Dimitri, good save, and they score! Gabrick was stopped on the first try. He batted in his own rebound. And the Wild take a 2-1 lead.
And he'll set up Gabrick with the pass. Now the first save is made. A beautiful save by Lundqvist. And Gabrick knocks it out of midair right there. That puck is at his waist when he bats it in over the shoulder. Dimitra with the hands. Parrish first. Dimitra, shot, save, rebound. He batted it right in. That's the great hands of Marian Gabrick. And the Wild haven't had many shots in this game and suddenly lead it 2-1 on the power play goal.
The second power play, 1-for-1 of the game. Here, Mark Bouchard, Brent Burns. Now it's Gabrick. And he scores! It's a hat trick for Marian Gabrick. 3 in a row. And the Wild take a 3-1 lead as Gabrick is putting on a show.
He saw that he had room. He decided to hold off on the shot and try and change his angle right there and go to the backhand. The puck ended up getting deflected on the backhand shot up high. But here it is again. Somebody's got to go to him right away. The problem Tootin had is that he couldn't fight through the man to get over to Gabrick. See, Tootin in front of the net, but he's got Boros in front of him, so he can't get there. And Shanahan tried to come back from the weak side and put pressure on Gabrick. Parrish, I believe, that deflected it. He's one of the best in the league at deflecting pucks in front of the net.
Keep in by Bouchard. Gabrick looks so dangerous every time he gets the puck. Bouchard scores! Oh, the Rangers are getting killed. It looks like Mark Parrish may have tipped it in front.
Best in the game in front of the net at screening and deflecting. Bouchard keeps it in, and now they work it around. Gabrick, and then the shot. And I think it was Parrish. He always sets up so that he screens the goaltender, but he's fearless in front of the net. And just gets a piece of it. Through the legs. And I think he got a piece of it with the shaft of his leaf.
Dimitra against Girardi. Fired, went off the shoulder of Lundqvist. Another shot blocked in front. They score! Marian Gabrick with his fourth of the game.
Great hands. The initial shot from a bad angle right here goes off the shoulder. Now all this traffic in front. Lundqvist makes one save and the quick stick of Gabrick. You got to get his stick. Drury is there. See how close he is? Shanahan's there. Girardi's there. Gabrick is in the middle of all of them. Everyone is within a foot or two from Gabrick, and another one he knocks out of midair. I'm getting tired of these goaltenders taking a dive. No, I'm serious. He got touched, and here comes
here
Gabrick.
Here comes Gabrick on a breakaway. Gabrick has five. It's Marian Gabrick night in St. Paul. 6-3 lead.
Look at the anticipation. Oh, boy. What a night. What a night of hockey this has been. Gabrick with the anticipation and just steals the puck. Down he goes. And he can score in so many different ways. And look at the quick release. Bang. In the net. Hardly before Lundqvist can move.
He goes to Kindle. Now Terry Filppula works it in. Filppula drops it back, and the quick shot stopped by Leonard. Rebound, score! Johan Franzen! And the game is tied at one.
This is off a line change, and this shows you how aware Valtteri Filppula is in all situations. You see the white sweaters. They're going to go for a change. Stretch everything out. Watch the reinforcements come off the bench.
Howard swatted that away, and Cromwell goes ahead to Bertuzzi. In come the Red Wings. Todd Bertuzzi drops it back for Zetterberg. Zetterberg back in front. Franson scores! That's two for Franson, and a 2-1 lead for the Red Wings.
Goals on the year for Johan Franson. And again, it's a transition game of Detroit. Move it quick. It's not just about the skating. Create a mini tour.
And Zetterberg quickly up ahead for Franson. Johan Franson comes pulling in. Shoots, scores! Hat trick, Johan Franson!
And the hats keep raining out of the crowd. Thanks, Mark. It's a Red Wings cap. Mark Wheeler just brought over. I'll give it to the Red Wings trainer, Pete Van Zandt.
Like he doesn't have any?
I know.
Give it to a kid. What are you doing?
I'll get it back.
Pete Van Zandt's got a closet full of Red Wings stuff. Another forward out there. Lidstrom and Rafalski work the points. Here's Lidstrom across to Rafalski. Fires it wide out the other side. Franson scores. That's four for Johan Franson. And just like that, Detroit has taken the lead for the fourth time in the game.
Gord, I know there's time and space, but they interchange a defenseman.
Pollock lost it. Lidstrom ahead to Franson. Shovel going ahead for Bertuzzi. If the empty net, he can't connect, and now Kovalev with it. Now Zetterberg intercepts. He drops for Franson. Johan Franson, five! And the Red Wings were trying to get him that all the way.
This is a personification of team and guys that get winning and the importance of chemistry. And Henrik Zetterberg, one of the alternate captains, he gets that.
Is it beyond Colton Parayko. Jets center. They score! Line A from the slot. And it's 2-1 Winnipeg.
There you see the shake and bake there by Connor. He goes wide. Edmondson goes in to take that hit. Now, there's the play on the side by Little. He takes the hit from Parayko. On the stick and off the stick of Line A.
Two goals in 41 seconds. Sam Wheeler again. Across and out. One-timer by Line A. Oh and my. That goes high. Line A again, and he scores. He does not miss from that spot, and he makes it 3-2 Winnipeg.
Going down the other way. Oh, what a play there by Scheifele. Lifts the stick of Braden Schenn. As that pass is coming across.
Down to the Jets with numbers the other way. Little to Connor to Line A, and he scores. And the hat trick for Line A, and it's 5-2.
And unfortunately for Vince Dunn, he makes a good play in the offensive zone. He just tries to wheel around. He's trying to create a little chaos in the O zone and somewhat toe picks there, and obviously a 3-on-1 going the other way.
Well, Line A worked over by Sundqvist. He stole it, but then lost it. And the shot off the goal posted in by Line A. For his fourth goal tonight. And the Jets a 6-2 lead.
Sundqvist does a nice job behind the net battling. He wins the battle, and there's where he tries to get it around one more player, which was the centerman Little. And who's there? But Line A. And look at the quick hands. He pulls this out here, drags it back, and somehow finds it short side. Get close to him.
Yeah, the Blues 14 shots tonight. Line A again, and he scores his fifth goal. And it's 7-2. What a show by the Finn.
Making it look easy. It's only his fifth shot of the game. And there's Little down low. And in the most dangerous part of the ice is the high
looks
slot.
Toward the net. Beats Panarin for the shot. Score! Deflected in off of Mika Zibanejad. Mika Zibanejad. It's a power play goal. The Rangers tie it.
And as just about everything else Zibanejad is doing, he does the right thing here. Beautiful redirection right there. Puck was about a foot off the ice and Zibanejad deflects it in.
Rangers will get an extra man on. They do. Shot by Zibanejad. He scores! Mika Zibanejad with a big drive. And the Rangers take a 2-1 lead.
Zibanejad draws the penalty on Kuznetsov. nets up. And then the Rangers, they don't just stop, they just keep going.
These teams, outstanding third period teams this season. A giveaway to which David Chipman score! It's a hat trick for Mika Zibanejad! And the Rangers lead it 4-3! How about that? And the hats come out!
And then this play, the pressure by Buchnevich forces the turnover, and then that beautiful little backhand pass and Zibanejad has the open end on the short side. Samsonov over on the other side. What a goal. What a start.
Kapokako winds up. Big shot. Save. Rebound. Score! Mika Zibanejad. It's a power play goal. His fourth goal of the game. And the Rangers lead it 5-4. The last time a Ranger scored four goals in the game was in 2011 when Ryan Callahan scored four. Angle shot. Panarin. Up the middle, Zibanejad. He goes to the net. He scores! He scores! The Rangers win! Mika Zibanejad with five goals! Do you believe it? Mika Zibanejad with five goals leads the Rangers to a 6-5 overtime win.
Is there anybody better on breakaways in this league than Mika Zibanejad? There's Panarin going back to get it. Head up, here it is, right on the tape. And Zibanejad does the rest. He goes to that backhand and he goes up high underneath the crossbar. We've seen it so often. Beautiful pass from Panarin.
Seven. Here's a break. Burns up the middle. Poke checked away by Jonathan Quick, who gets a pat in the head right after that by Drew Doughty. Here's Burns back with it again. To the other side. Timo Meier scores! A power play goal, and the Sharks up early. Saved by Quick, and now Meier scores again! Timo Meier, red hot in this first period, makes it 3-0. They have the puck, yes. When they haven't had the puck in their own end, I'm not sure. Here's Meier again, and he almost had a hat trick. He still gets after it, and he's got it. A first period hat trick for Timo Meier. Stands here at SAP Center for Timo Meier, having the first half of a season of a lifetime.
Tomas Hertl.
Shoot that thing. You got Logan right there in the perfect position.
Far side, a rip by Meier. That's four! And does he have more? Timo Meier, a four-goal game. Final half minute of the second period. It's Hertl. Across for Meier. Toe drag. He did it! History at the Shark Tank as Timo Meier becomes the first San Jose Shark in 31 years to score five goals in a game.
Down the wall away from Corrali, gets the puck back and now serves it to the line for Dahlin. Right side, Cousins to the net with a shot. They score! Dylan Cousins on the power play. His 10th of the year, and it's 1-0 Buffalo.
As well, and not the big 100-mile-an-hour one-timer from Tage Thompson, but you can see the setup right here and the way that Dahlin disguised it. Looks like he might be going over to Thompson, plays it over to Cousins. Cousins has room there. And this goes off the inside of the blocker, off the inside of the belly pad on the right by the rib.
Nice setup by Gaudreau and a good look for Laine. Now it's Alex Tuck the other way. The backhand to the slot and they score! Tage Thompson pulled that one to the backhand with Korpisalo sliding across the net. And it was a wide open goal for Tage Thompson.
Not mistaken. And now it goes the other way. And it's a track meet right there. Pass over to the left. And here comes Tucky. Plays it to the backhand. And look at that. You talk about a forehand backhand. Thanks for coming right there. The goaltender's moving to his left. Can't get traction back to his right. Stop that bleeding.
Well, here come the Sabres challenging again. Tuck trying to find it. He does. And he finds Thompson. And he scores! Four goals on four straight shots against two different goalies for the Buffalo Sabres.
And power takes a hit right there by Olivier. Gets that puck up the ice. And in one quick motion, you can see Tuck right there. Tuck's tangled up the stick of Gavrikov. And he wins that battle. And once it gets over there to Tage Thompson, he just kind of waits as long as he can and just shuffles this one right under the bar.
Halfway through the 4 minutes. And the only two shots during the Sabres power play have been shorthanded by Columbus. Thompson scores! And it's a hat trick!
And that is a 100-mile-an-hour one-timer. I mean, when you see this play off the board, Dylan Cousins just banks it off the boards. So this unit come out for the second time on the power play. The first time they were out.
5-on-3. Thompson wants it, gets it, gives it back. They work it over. Thompson again to Skinner. To Thompson. Four goals for Tage Thompson. Brilliant passing on the 5-on-3. And Tage Thompson has just set a Sabres record with his fourth goal in a period.
They recognize that that's beyond three right there, but here's the play, and it's almost like they were at first reluctant to go back to Tage Thompson, but they put it right on the dot right there, and there are no secrets to this play right here. He actually didn't get
Alex Tuck over. Thompson loads it up, scores! Number five for Tage Thompson!
That is unbelievable. That's going to be in that spot. Mike Bossy, same way. Mike Bossy didn't look where he knew where that puck was going to be.